Hello y'all, welcome back to another video dedicated to help you break out of any toxic behaviors or patterns in your romantic or relationship life. I'm Coach Jeanette from @jeanette.xzito on TikTok and Instagram, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about why it's so hard to break out of toxic relationships. Now, if you've ever been in, or maybe you're in a toxic relationship right now, you've probably heard your friends and family ask you multiple times why you're still in the relationship. Maybe they even disapprove of the relationship and asked you to break up multiple times. And if you've been in this situation before, you've probably either responded in one, denial, because this relationship is so familiar to what you think love looks like, or you know deep down inside that it's an unhealthy relationship, but you don't want to admit it because this is just something that you're so used to. And I know how you feel. And the truth is, it's easier said than done regardless, because it's not just breaking out of a relationship, but it's also breaking out of an addiction. You might be asking, what do you mean an addiction, Jeanette? Now, the truth is, most toxic relationships form what we call a trauma bond. And here are some signs you might be in a trauma bond with someone. One, you feel stuck and can't leave this bond with someone, even if they're treating you poorly. Two, you feel the need to change or fix this person. Three, you're having the same arguments over and over again that lead to nowhere. Four, if you try to detach, you feel this huge sense of longing and pain for this person. And five, people are disturbed or concerned about a comment or action that your partner made, but you're not. Now, what a trauma bond relationship looks like is this cycle of highs and lows, and where the highs would be this reward system, and the lows would be this punishment system. The lows in the relationship would be any form of abuse or manipulation. This can be gaslighting, dismissing your emotions, invalidating your feelings, even stonewalling or silent treatment, or making you feel bad about your emotions. The highs would be making you feel good about yourself all of a sudden. And some of this can be from giving you gifts, compliments, making you feel good, telling you these nice, sweet things. The truth is, as the cycle continues, some of the highs is going to turn into some of the bare minimum. For example, all of a sudden they respect your decision. All of a sudden they're listening to your emotions. But if you really think about it, these things are bare minimums, but they make it seem as if it's this grand thing only because you've been through this cycle of lows and highs. Now, as these highs and lows are being intermittently reinforced, what it's creating is this addiction and anticipation where you're unsure of what's going to happen next. So you're constantly stuck in this state of fight or flight, always on your toes, like walking around eggshells, thinking about, oh, I hope all of a sudden they don't blow up, or maybe they'll come home and it'll be a good day today. And an analogy that I like to use is gambling. So just like gambling, sometimes you win a load of money and you feel this high, right? But then sometimes you lose a lot of money and you're unsure if you should keep on gambling, because you want to win the money and you know it's possible, but you're having these unsure moments because it's not something that you can predict. Just like how gamblers can form an addiction, it's that unpredictability-ness that makes us crave and want that high again. And the more extreme the rewards and punishments are, the more extreme you're going to be addicted in this cycle. Now, most people try to break out of this trauma bond by just ending the relationship and breaking up. And if you've been in a toxic relationship before, you know that most of the time it doesn't work that easily. Because what ends up happening is that you go back to the relationship, your friends find out, they tell you and nag you about it, saying, ugh, why are you back with them again? And you're stuck in this on and off relationship over and over again until one of you guys is exhausted and leaves for good. But to prevent that from happening, we want to understand why we keep going back over and over again. And like I said before, a trauma bond is formed between wounds between one person and another. If you think about it this way, person A and person B both have wounds that connect them to each other, right? And the most common wound that I see in a toxic relationship is fear of abandonment. Now, as an example, person A has fear of abandonment, but the way that they show up with this wound is by clinging on, calling constantly, texting constantly, wanting person B's attention. And person B shows this fear of abandonment wound by withdrawing, putting up their walls, emotionally shutting down, because they don't want to put themselves in a position where they can lose person A and then be abandoned. Not only do we want to cut the person off cold turkey, no contact, but we also want to start healing those wounds within ourselves so we can prevent future trauma bonds and prevent ourselves from going back into the relationship. So if we have this fear of abandonment, we want to start healing that wound within ourselves. This means not abandoning ourselves by showing up whenever we need to set boundaries, listening to our emotions and needs, and also not constantly looking externally to feel safe, but also internally. Now, if you want a part two and how you can start healing from a trauma bond or breakup, let me know in the comments down below. And you can always reach out on Instagram and send me a DM if you're ever looking for more one-on-one guidance as well. Also, if you're looking for a community full of love and support, join our Facebook group as well. All the links will be in the description box below. If you enjoyed this video today, make sure that you leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And I hope to see you in our next video. As always, you got this.